traffic noise, loud pell-mell. For people with a hearing disorder, holding a conversation here is extremely difficult. For the deaf, it is even worse. Not a sound, no acoustic information reaches them. Yet science can restore the hearing of completely deaf people too, with so-called cochlear implants, the first sensory prosthesis suitable for everyday use. They are Professor Werner Hemmert's field of research at the Institute of Medical Engineering at the Technische Universität München. A high-performance computer in a miniature format processes sound waves to electric impulses and conducts them to the inner ear. In a healthy ear, sensory cells convey sound waves to the auditory nerve. When these cells are damaged, the implant can assume their function. The electrodes in the processing unit are inserted into the skull bone behind the ear in surgery. This is a routine operation in the hands of an experienced surgeon. 4 weeks later, the adaption of the processor begins at the clinic. The patient must learn to hear from anew. Our brain is incredibly flexible and manages to analyze data in ways that seem unlikely. Yet technology has its limits. Mastering spatial hearing has so far been well nigh impossible. Sound waves usually first reach one ear and then the other. The brain uses the resulting tiny time difference to pinpoint the source of the sound. Professor Hemmert and his team are developing strategies that will make spatial hearing with implants possible in the future. We are now trying to understand how neuronal processing works, at least in the first levels of the brain, the auditory system, and then we can adapt the coding strategy. A classical concert. Although cochlear implants can reproduce rhythm quite well, patients can hardly distinguish more complex sounds. Music is, of course, a big challenge. A hearing person can distinguish between over 1,000 tones. But in a cochlear implant, we have only 12 or 22 electrodes. A possible solution might be to stimulate the auditory nerve with light rather than electrically. Electricity spreads spherically in the fluid spaces of the inner ear, that is to say, very broadly, while light beams can be focused on a very small area of the nerve. For the deaf, understanding speech again is a great gift. A better understanding of signal processing in the brain, combined with increasingly powerful microprocessors, will open new doors in the near future.